actually signed. Horford is out there with Williams, and it's Nesmith in at the small forward spot for the 76ers. And the small and power forwards are Thibodeau and Harris. Maxey out there with Harden, and it's Embiid in at the five spot.
Early on, three misses to open the game. Their offense right now still trying to find its way.
The Celtics have gone 0-3 from the field to start the game. Crowd wide open, he fires. Good, and Smart gets the assist. For the teams that are clearly rebuilding, Greg, should they simply play the young guns no matter what, or should they make them earn their minutes?
I think there should be a combination. And as long as guys are pros and really approaching the game the right way, you want to give them an opportunity to grow, and also it gives you a chance to evaluate.
Smart kicks to Horford. Smart. Six to shoot. Nesmith, the pass to Williams. Shoots over Embiid. And Philadelphia grabs the miss. Last meeting was in Boston, where they were unable to fight off the Celtics.
Live by the three, die by the three. If you're perimeter dependent, you don't really know game to game how it's going to go.
You know, I think the lack of success from the perimeter really did them in. They just couldn't get it going from there.
Nesmith. Back to Horford. Outside, Smart. Down to five on the shot clock. Williams trying to break free.
Good challenge that time by Embiid, using all that length quite well.
Here's Thibodeau. Here's Harden. Plays it up and banks it in.
And once he got to the 10, I think he was surprised to find himself that wide open.
Well, this early, they should be showing a lot more energy on defense. It's not there.
Now here's Williams. He picked up 12 points in their last win against the Pacers in Indianapolis.
Yeah, but you can't talk about his performance without mentioning what he did defensively in terms of shot blocking. He was a force of nature.
Celtics trail by three. Some tough offensive sets. They want to turn it around.
Yeah, right now you just need a bucket to get some momentum.
Now Smart. Taking a look at his stats, he's averaging around 7.5 points a game. It's deflected. The Celtics need to get a shot off. Here's Williams. Misses, and the dry spell continues. And so it's Harris who will bring it up for the Philadelphia 76ers.
And you watch Harris. He's been playing with a high level of confidence.
Well, Greg, he puts the work in during the offseason. It's obvious. That's why his game looks like it comes easier to him now, because he's refined it through his work in the offseason. And in a lot of ways, he's bearing the fruit of that labor, and it's fun to see. He's as solid as it gets from the line. I mean, give him the opportunity, he's cashing in on those.
So the Celtics call timeout. They're first.
Trying to find some answers offensively.
Yeah, and you know, that's going to be the focus of this timeout. They need to come up with a spark to get the offense going.
Now here's Smart. Here's Brown. And it goes out of bounds. Last touch by Embiid. Approaching about 3.5 minutes played in the first quarter. Smart passes to Nesmith. Shot clock at 6. Passes it to Horford. Williams trying to break free.
In building this lead, they've done a terrific job finishing the defensive sequences with the backcourt. That has been key.
Yeah, you're right. Not one second chance bucket for the opposition. They're boxing out on every shot.
Here's Nesmith. No good. They had a chance to end the run there. Philadelphia leading by 5. Pass to Maxey. And slam dunk by Maxey.
Harden's done a nice job really increasing his playmaking over the last few years and excels at finding teammates.
And here's Smart. He's been patient so far. Nothing on the scoreboard yet. Brown with it. Picked up by Harris. And it's Brown missing.
And he has definitely been struggling in this quarter.
You know, guys, it seems to me as though he's over-anxious. He seems to be aggressive, trying too hard, moving too fast. Just needs to calm himself down and wait for good shots.
Time call here. The Celtics decide to talk it over.
Well, it's been an express lane to the rim. Coach can't be happy about that.
And, you know, I think he's going to tell them simply, we have to show more fight on the interior. That's the top priority right now.
Let's see some of the numbers here for Jaylen Brown.
And you can see the surge in his level of confidence lately. Just by looking at that true shooting percentage, it's been moving straight up in the past five games. I think he's feeling it.
And that's out of bounds. Boston will retain possession. It up off the inbound.
Yeah, that's another miss for him. They're behind in this game largely because he shot so poorly.
Here's Maxey. It's tipped. Smart with the ball. Brown outside. Pass to Nesmith. Outside, Smart. Pocket six. And there's the whistle. Illegal screen.
And here's a look at the stats for Harris. This past month, he's really set himself apart. He's right around 13 points a night, 6 rebounds, and 4 assists. And he's such a big part of what they do offensively.
Yeah, he's just got that nice feel, that sixth sense, knowing where to be on the floor to help his teammates generate points.
It's good. The assist that time from Harden. Harden's got 3 assists now in this one.
And the defense looks soft early on. They've got to sum it up. A little more sense of urgency.
Yeah, they've got to do a little more to disrupt their offensive rhythm, too.
And it's Brown missing.
Well, you have to like their work on the boards, Kevin, particularly here to start the game.
Yeah, I like the way they're setting the tone. They've been really playing with a lot of energy here at the start.
Excellent all-around performance so far. Hence the big lead.
Yeah, you know, they've had the advantage at both ends. They've got all the momentum early on.
Now, here's Smart. Still getting warmed up offensively. No scoring yet from him.
A fantastic defender. Embiid is consistent, not only blocking shots, but going at them as well, especially when he's in the air.
The screen intensity right off the opening tip, especially on the offensive end.
Tell you what, forget about easing into the game. They came out with guns blazing.
Out left to the wing. Out to the wing. Now, here's Nesmith. Guarded by Embiid. Nesmith can't get it to go. And Embiid has got the ball here for Philadelphia. Dibble with the ball. Working on Williams. Williams with the clock.
The amazing thing about Williams, yeah, he can block shots inside, but he can also block shots out on the perimeter. His ability to play in space means he's more than just a rim protector. Doesn't care where you're shooting from.
Danny Green, he's checked in for Philadelphia.
Jaylen.
Hands it from downtown.
Very aggressive in terms of looking for his shot. 9 attempts already, but only able to knock down 2.
Harden dishes to Green. Harden kicks to Green. Off the left rim and out.
That's a shot he's got to hit. You don't get many looks better from that range.
Out of bounds, it'll be 76ers ball. We have a chance now to look at the teams that have created the most points off turnovers this season. The 76ers, number 1.
And all those points off turnovers have been a huge bonus. I mean, that aggressive defense has also paid dividends at the offensive end of the floor.
And there's the foul. It's on Jaylen Brown. That's his first foul. And some changes here for the 76ers. DeAndre Jordan's checked in for Embiid. George Niang comes in for Tobias Harris. And it's Korkmaz in for James Harden. Williams, he's checked in for Boston. Derek White comes in for Brown. The 76ers with another miss.
Look at him, and he's a little hit and miss from there. Even without a defender in his face. No guarantee.
There's the pass to Pritchard. passes it to Tice. It's White on the wing. Shoots from the corner. Green with the rebound. Philadelphia leading by 13. Here's Kortmaz. And it's White with the rebound.
Well, what appeared to be an easy 2 points just never materialized.
With the teardrop, and that's 2 points on the layup.
Nice selection that time by White, going to the floater. Every guard needs to have that in his back pocket.
And the 76ers decide to take their first timeout here. They defeated Charlotte in their last game.
Yeah, I felt like they attacked, but with a purpose. They knew what they wanted to accomplish coming in.
Boy, it really showed the trust they have in one another. I love how they got after it. Why? You could feel that they were playing for each other.
And the 76ers making a change here. Milton's checked in. And we'll get a look at how the Hustlestat game has been going for the 76ers.
You know, they've done a great job of getting a hand up on shooters. Actually, have gotten a lot of blocks as well, solidifying that defensive effort.
And the other thing that's been equally as effective is the fact that they've gotten out on the fast break. A lot of points coming in transition.
The 76ers leading by 13. Aston Niang, 76ers moving the ball around. A shot by Jordan, no good.
Just enough coverage to bother that three-point attempt.
Pass to Pritchard. Here is Williams. He's gotten some minutes, but nothing on the board yet. And the Eastern Conference has been fun to watch. A lot of focus, as always, this year. And as we hit the mid-season surge, let's check out the standings and how they're shaping up. Look at Philadelphia. They're having a solid season. Fifth in the conference and looking to move up. And, of course, there's the Celtics, four games back.
And seeing where the 76ers are, this hasn't been the breakout season that many were predicting, but they're still very much in the hunt for a high postseason seed. And that will keep them focused here during the season's final stages.
And they need to stay focused. I mean, they have to ensure they hang on to a high seed. It's imperative for them.
Now here's White. 14 points from him the last game against Indiana.
And it seemed like he spent about half the game shooting free throws. Credit him for really taking it to the defense.
Here's Milton. Following the basket by Derek White. And that one good. And the 76ers lead by 13.
When you allow good scorers to get uncontested shots at the rim, no wonder you're losing.
You know, he should be getting extra attention from the defense, not less.
Now here's Williams. Milton grabs the board.
Well, you know, this is what happens. You can't afford to lose concentration, even for a nanosecond.
Right in the lane.
And they have owned the paint so far, and the score reflects it.
And, you know, establishing that physical dominance early gives you a big mental edge, too. Don't discount that.
Pass to Williams. Here's Pritchard, wide open. And he gets the friendly spin, and that one drops.
Ball distribution was there. I mean, outstanding work all the way around.
Here's Kortmaz, and he takes that one up and powers it through.
The knee just kind of stepping aside and letting him get to the rim.
There's a reason, GA, the lead is what it is right now.
You know, you look at it, the communication is lacking, as is the trust. They can ill afford those types of breakdowns. It won't work. You can't win with those kind of breakdowns.
Philadelphia with the ball, following the bucket by the Celtics. It's blocked, and he's able to get it back. Here's Kortmaz. Here's Green. 1:03 left in the first quarter of the game. From 12 feet out, that misses off the back. Kortmaz, light covering, and out of bounds as the Celtics gain possession. And some changes here for the Celtics. Luke Kornet comes in for Daniel Tice, and Stauskas subbed in for Pritchard. Now White, he's got six. He goes up again. His fourth miss of the game. He's made three. The 76ers leading by 13. Massey, the pass to Kortmaz. Inside, here's Milson, and contact on the shot, so he'll be shooting free throws here.
And you've got to love it. I mean, Millsap drawing contact, not afraid to get banged around a little bit.
The 76ers shooting their fifth and sixth free throws of the game.
Shoot two.
No good on that.
You know, it took a little time for Millsap to develop and blossom into the NBA player he is, but once he did blossom, this guy became a star quickly.
Austin making a switch here. Morgan's checked in. Celtics trail by 14, about 7 seconds separating the shot and game clocks. It's 2-on-1, and he's going up for the alley-oop.
Well, there you go. One team operating on all cylinders at both ends. Steals, fast break buckets, and the other team in scramble mode.
Austin's gone 2-of-2 from three-point range here in the first quarter. Now here's White. Three on the clock.
Smart on the defensive end. Now Millsap, very impressive. That IQ he has on defense, recognizes the move and then closes the airspace.
And so it's Philadelphia in command with a 16-point lead. And so far through one quarter, it's been a lopsided game. We'll see if that changes here in the second. And the 76ers have been rolling along, haven't they?
You got to credit their defense, communicating, rotating, making plays on the ball.
They've got them rattled. It's only the first quarter, and already they've made enough big plays on defense to last really an entire game.
So with Harden on the bench, here's the five for Doc Rivers right now. Cork Bonds is out there with Shake Milton. Then there's Paul Millsap, and it's Bassey in at the four. Stauskas, the pass to Morgan. Now here's White. As he pulls it in.
And you can see the defenders afraid to kind of get in his way a lot of times when he's on his way to the basket. But on that one, they were there.
Here's Bass. It's deflected. And up the court come the Celtics on the break. Here's Stauskas. White the pass to Cornette. Just five to shoot. A shot. And that one hits back iron.
Scoring efficiency has been low, and it's not helping them on the scoreboard. And this guy, to me, embodies determination. Small in his position, but he still gets up and keeps plays alive. That's mind over matter for sure.
Here's White. Yes, that goes in. White's got eight.
Outstanding concentration that time by White on the tape. Played through the contact and scored.
The pass to Millsap. Out to the right wing. The end. Offline with his three. Celtics trail by 18. Second quarter of play with around 2 minutes gone so far. He pulls it in for Philadelphia. They've gone 2-of-4 shooting the ball here in the second. Millsap kicks to Niang. That's good. It's Millsap with the assists. Niang's got his first points of the night.
And guys, they continue to put a lot of pressure on the interior defenders with their work down low.
White, wide open. He fires off the mark there with the three-point shot.
He's certainly been cold this quarter, guys, but trying to shoot his way back into a groove.
Let's go now to the sideline and catch up with David Aldridge.
Thank you, Kevin. The Celtics made the Eastern Conference Finals 3 times over 4 seasons, but last season, injuries and COVID protocols knocked them down a peg. Ownership and management are patiently staying the course. And with their young star talent, this team still has room to improve from within. Guys, back to you.
The other upside in a lot of people's view remains. David, thanks. And the call on the shot sends him to the line. And down the road, Greg, which current player might make for the best? best coach.
Well, I'm always partial to the point guard. And if you're looking for leadership, man, Chris Paul, Mike Conley, those guys, I think, are destined to coach. I think LeBron would be a great one as well, but I got a sneaky suspicion he'd just rather own the team.
And it's a completely new group here for Philadelphia. He's perfect from the line this time. And it's the 76ers with the ball. Harden outside. And Embiid, the bucket on the assist by Harden. Embiid's got his third bucket of the night.
And the crisp passing has opened things up for them offensively.
10 straight points off assist. That's very impressive. And it also makes the game easy and fun to watch.
And it's Brown missing. The 76ers leading by 20. Harris passes to Embiid. Fires from deep. Harris, no good. And here's Brown. He'll bring it up for the Celtics. They defeated Indiana in their last game.
Remarkable consistency from deep. You can't count on that every game, especially on the road.
You know, the defense had no answer for him. To do that kind of damage on the road, impressive.
Now here's Embiid, following the missed shot by Tobias Harris. And Embiid with the block. And so it looks like the Celtics will retain possession here. Neesmith, he's checked in for the Celtics. Outside, Smart. And here is Neesmith. 9 points last game. Just 4 to shoot. From 11 feet away, shooting foul. As the whistle blows, he'll shoot 2 free throws.
I mean, even from over here, you can see that one pretty clearly.
No question about it. I mean, a ton of contact and a good call by the officials.
The Celtics shooting their 3rd and 4th free throw shots of the night.
And when you got a team percentage of about 81%, you're going to be one of the elites in this league.
Really, guys, it's just come together for them at the charity stripe this season. I mean, the confidence is there, and so too are the results.
That's good from Neesmith. Both free throws.
And working, Kevin, themselves to the line here in the second. A nice way to get your offense going.
And maybe cause some foul trouble along the way as well. We know what that can do. It pays off typically in good fashion for you.
Yeah, nice play by Smart. Under control and transition, something also he's improved at.
Harden the pass to Maxey. And it goes down 2 points. Maxey's got 6.
Another bucket down low. They've been the aggressors, taking the ball inside and attacking at the rim.
You're exactly right. It's been all good at one end, and let's be diplomatic and just say not so good at the other end.
Brown. Horford dishes to Brown. And the rejection by Harden. And the ball travels out of bounds. It was last touched by Harden. Gets to Smart. 6 on the shot clock. Goes up again. There's another block.
A defensive stalwart so far. That's 6 blocks.
Greg protecting the rim. Love the hustle. Clock at 2. Off the inbound pass. The shot. No good. And Philadelphia the other way now.
Hard-pressed to find someone more confident than Embiid.
He's got plenty of confidence. He's a funny guy, too. Extremely entertaining. He said, the mindset I get when I'm on the floor is that I'm the best player in the gym. And much of the time, he ain't wrong.
Here's Horford. 76ers getting the bucket. Williams finds Brown. Uses the glass to finish the lane. He's got 8.
He's giving himself a chance. 6 shots he's gotten up this quarter, but only able to convert on one of them.
rebound by Williams. Williams has got 6 rebounds here tonight. Outside, Smart. Passes it to Neesmith. It's Williams, high post. And there's the call on Joel Embiid. That's foul number 2 for him.
And that's foul number 2. Maybe you don't sit him at this point, but you really have to be careful to not pick up another before half.
Matisse Thybulles checked in for Reed. The Celtics also changing it up. Daniel Tice is checked in for Williams. And it's Pritchard in for Marcus Smart. Now, here's Tice. Still looking for his first bucket in this one. Here's Harris. And it's sent back by Horford.
Horford relentless as a defender in good position. That shot never had a chance.
A three. And Philadelphia grabs the miss. Embiid's got rebound number 9 now. What an effort here tonight. Some nice ball movement here by the 76ers. Harris passes to Thibault. And the officials calling for a 3-second violation. Celtics trail by 18. Guys, they're looking for a way to score here.
Yeah, they've had a tough time taking the lid off.
Now, here's Neesmith. Defense right on him. Fires from 18. The rebound by Harden. Harden's got his 4th rebound in this one.
And that assist got a nod from his teammate after that one.
Now a timeout called by Boston. And Harden really looks like he's been having fun out there.
I would agree with that, Kevin. And he says he's the same way off the court, too. I don't know him off the court, but he says he loves meeting new people. I don't have any trouble believing that. He enjoys engaging with kids. And certainly the bright tennis shoes are part of everybody's NBA attire now, but he wears it as an expression of his personality.
Pass to Tice, stolen by Harden, 3-on-3, and the jam by Harden.
Boy, the slam from the beard, elevated a little bit. James can go from 0 to 100, pretty quick for a guy this size.
Here's Pritchard, he's averaging a bit over 5 points a game. And the whistle blows, it's going to be on Tyrese Maxey. That'll be his 2nd foul of the game. Pass to Pritchard. Two free throws coming up, and they call the shooting foul. That one on Maxey. It's his first trip to the line. That free throw, no good. And last season, All-Stars Greg missing 19% of their available games. With the shortened off seasons, are you concerned about the toll it takes?
You are, but this offseason maybe not as painfully short as the last one. And in these tough times, some sacrifices are made, no doubt. Health, perhaps, one of the biggest.
Now, here is Harden. 22 points in the win against Charlotte.
Offensively, defensively, they are in total control.
And don't leave out the coaching staff here now. I mean, their game plan has been perfect.
Harden against Brown. Driving to the basket, and the shot goes down. Brown's got 10 points in the game.
And Brown really is at his best when he takes it inside. I mean, defense has no idea what to do with it.
Harden, no good. And here's Brown. He'll bring it up for Boston. Over Maxey. Brown, good. Brown's got 6 points in the quarter.
Watch out now. When this guy gets into a rhythm, it is something to behold.
Here's Maxey. And it's blocked by Brown. And there's the call on Joel Embiid. That's his 3rd foul so far. Bonus situation in effect, so we'll head to the free throw line for 2. This is his first trip to the line tonight.
And to this point on the season, guys, 80% from the line. He's done a really good job.
Boy, I tell you what, he's really coming to his own this year. I mean, that is an enormous step up from what he shot at the line last season.
Jordan, he's checked in for Philadelphia. Green comes in for Maxey.
Oh, yes, sir. Come on, Green. And Harden, an absolute vicious nice dunker. Terrific at bouncing towards the rim for the epic throwdown.
A tremendous Mobile One block that we had to see again. Great send back.
And guys, that block could really help change the momentum of this game.
Jaylen.
Oh boy, to be young again.
Makes you nostalgic, doesn't it?
Yeah, it does make me look back a little bit, but I could never throw it down like that. It sure does look good.
And Philadelphia has possession, following the bucket by the Celtics.
Boy, I tell you what, the defender did a good job trying to challenge that shot, but Jordan's strength caused him to create the foul.
Austin Ogden is rich here. Stauskas is checked in.
And really an incredible playmaker his entire career. Harden has taken that up a notch, and he now often looks for his teammates first.
Here's Pritchard. It's hauled in by the 76ers. Harris has got his fifth rebound right now in the game. And he finds Jordan. Right side Green. Here's Tybal. Now the pass to Harris. Buries it from three-point range. Harris has got eight. Assist totals for Harden, which is also a reflection, Greg, of the talent around him.
And he's played with some of the best finishers in the game throughout his career. What changed starting last year was his mindset, making him all that much more difficult to defend.
Here's Stauskas. Drops in the layup for two. Stauskas has got his first 2 points of the night.
I like the play call. Very solid, making perfect use of the pick to get a great look.
Here's Jordan. And Boston with the rebound.
And the D does just enough to throw off his rhythm on that shot.
To the inside. And it's blocked by Jordan.
Hey, you know he's around, and that's what he does. DeAndre Jordan throwing that shot out of there.
Harris kicks to Jordan. Good ball movement here by the 76ers. Feibel can't get it to go.
Very dangerous to leave a guy like that open. Lucky break there for the D.
Pass to Stauskas. Shot clock at six. Here's Pritchard, guarded by Jordan. A shot by Pritchard, no good. Philadelphia leading by 21. To the paint. Feibel on the wing. He's covered by Brown. Outside, Green. Harden, left side. And so it. The 76ers leading by 21. Starting the second half, here's Ime Udoka's five. Smart in the backcourt with Brown to his side. Bob Williams is out there with Horford. And it's Nesmith in at the three. Here's Smart. James Harden picking up that last basket. Williams, and Williams is right there. Williams has got his first points of the game.
Yeah, hard trying to keep Williams off the boards. He makes it a mission to keep possessions alive.
Okay, two hands for safety. That's what they say, right?
That's right. He was ultra safe with that dunk, no question.
And he should be. I mean, remove all doubt. Get it down hard and simple.
This is his third free throw attempt of the game.
And all you need to do is see his free throw percentage, guys, 90 for the season to know what kind of year he's had.
And you know, with those numbers, he makes a defender hesitant to get too tight on him. I mean, he doesn't want to get whistled for the foul and put this guy on.
Now here's Smart. Down low. Here's Horford. He clangs that one off the back iron and down it falls.
Now you cannot dismiss Horford's mid-range game. I mean, he's more than happy to rise up and splash those mid-range jumpers.
Now, here's Nesmith, defended by Feibel. Nesmith, the pass to Williams. Outside, Horford. Pass to Nesmith. Five on the clock. 20 feet out. And Embiid pulls it down.
And the well is running dry for him right now. Nothing falling.
And, you know, you can sense his frustration. This is going to be a test of his resolve here.
Now here is Harris. 8 points for him. And it's Thibault in the corner. good on that one. And the Celtics going the other way now. Brown outside. 2 minutes into the second half of play now. Outside, Horford. The Celtics keep it going. A new 14-second shot clock. And there's Brown. That's good on the assist by Williams. Brown's got 17 now.
Really good to see Brown drop in the perimeter jumper. Showing off his terrific stroke from beyond the arc.
Here's Maxey. And slam dunk by Maxey.
And he just pushes the D from falling asleep at the wheel.
A little disorganized that time. And the result, 2 points in the longest way possible.
Guys, there has to be better rim protection than that, though. Not very good.
Here's Horford. 76ers getting the button. Williams. And he gets the whistle. 2 free throws coming up.
You know, he just plays with such tenacity on both ends. Williams is a rising talent that wants to prove he belongs.
For Boston, they have been coming through at the charity stripe. They've made 7 of their 8 attempts. And that one falls for Williams. So he hits both. Well, we're into the third quarter, just over 2.5 minutes played. Driving inside. And that one's good, Maxey.
And that bucket adds to what has been a big difference in points in the paint between the two teams.
Yeah, it's really been quite a contrast. I like the way they're attacking the middle at their offensive end.
And the call will be against Harris. That's his first foul. George Niang, he's checked in for the 76ers. Williams against Embiid. Now here's Smart. D right on him. Up and in on the way. Smart.
For a guy who's still working on his range, love to see Smart attacking on the interior.
To the middle. It's tipped. Out with it. Now defended by Embiid. Smart, wide open. He fires. Here's Williams. The dunk and the foul. A powerhouse move. And he's got a chance for one more at the line. That one on Embiid. And the Celtics making a change here. This is his second trip to the line in this one.
And of course, we'd all like to see his percentage at the line improve. But he just does not have the touch right now. He's in the 60s.
Hey, guys, this has not been a season to remember for him at the free throw line. Certainly to this point.
Yep, that one goes. Maxey's got 9 points now, just the second half.
This shooting has been outstanding. Definitely one of the reasons they're up in this game.
Six to shoot. Williams trying to break free. It's blocked. They get it back. And the Celtics hit again from deep.
And they've shown a little extra hustle on the offensive glass here in the second half. Second chance points are starting to add up for them. They could use every one. And a hustle like that is why he leads his team in rebounds tonight.
I tell you what, guys, nobody's been more physical in this game than he has. He has been a glass eater.
Jake Milton, he's checked in for Philadelphia. Now here's Smart. He's got 7. And you know that's going to be goaltending, guys. So that's a free basket right there.
Wow, has he flipped the switch at halftime. Much more effective here in the second half.
The 76ers leading by 12. Here he goes. And he finishes it off with a one-handed jam.
Just rubbing it in their faces with that dunk.
He is never going to take his foot off the pedal.
And that's terribly demoralizing for a defense, guys. I mean, they know he's going to keep coming and coming and coming, and that they may not have an answer for it.
And this is where Smart has really improved. The game's slowed down for him. He's playing under better control. Nice pass.
Now, here is Reed. No points in the game yet for him. Now, here's Milton. guarded by Smart. Niang, no good.
And he didn't punish them for the weak coverage there, but they can count on him to continue missing. And what impressed me about Smart last year, and we're seeing it this year as well, is patience and precision as a playmaker.
Now, here's Milton. They get the rebound. Cassie. And no good. Trying to use the glass.
And being over the limit this early really can affect your aggressiveness defensively. They have got to play under control.
And we just got a second look there at the exceptional Mobile One block.
And this is how you protect and grow a lead, by making a huge effort on that end of the floor.
And the assist totals show how far Smart has come.
Averaging around 3 dimes a year at the start of his career, he's now doubling that effort when given the minutes. Good sign for him and this team.
And some changes here for the 76ers. Millsap comes in for George Niang, and it's Green and 4 Korkmaz. And so Smart nails both of them.
And some of what Smart gives this team doesn't always show up in the stat sheet, but he makes plays that help you win. No clue where that pass was going. That is a brutal turnover.
Celtics trail by 10. Pass to Morgan. Kicks to Smart. From deep 3-point range, it's hauled in by the 76ers. He's got rebound number 5 here tonight. Tries to save it, and it's out of bounds. The 76ers have a retained possession here. And Philadelphia making a change here. Harris is checked in, and the Celtics also making a change. Stauskas is checked in. And Harris wide open. He shoots. His 3-pointer's off the mark. Austin's gotten fewer than half of their 3-pointers to go down tonight. They're 4 for 9. To the left wing. Here's Morgan. Offensive rebound, Celtics. This one for 3. Nailed from 3-point land. Morgan's got it back down to within single digits for Boston. Milton kicks to Harris. That'll be 2 free throws coming up. Officials on the call with the foul.
You know, looking to score often from there, Harris is excellent at drawing the defense's attention and fouls.
76ers have gone 6 of 8 from the free throw line tonight. And he knocks down the first one. And Harris drops them both.
You know, over time, I think Harris has become really good at accepting more responsibility, and that's part of learning how to be a leader.
Here's Stauskas. Outside Williams. Let's it go with a 3. Hits it from 3-point range. Williams has got his first 3 points of the game.
It's been this way since halftime. Tremendous production from beyond the arc.
Boy, it's been a 3-point barrage. They came out gunning and have not stopped.
Now here is Harris. 10 points for him. And he gets it to go.
No way you can minimize his concentration. Excellent focus in finding a way to score that time by Harris.
Pritchard passes to Williams. Over to the wing. Not loose. Reed with the steal. And now the 76ers on the break. And here's Green outside. It's rebounded by Stauskas. Celtics trail by 8, and so Boston again turning it over. DeAndre Jordan's checked in for the 76ers. Axie comes in for Shake Milton. Daniel Tice is checked in for the Celtics. Here's Jordan. He averages a bit over 6 points a game. Outside, Green for a 3. Millsap, good, and it's Green picking up the assist. Millsap's got 6.
Millsap, this time with catch and fire, showing off his versatility.
Here's Stauskas, guarded by Harris. to the paint. Here's Tice. Rejected by Hicks. And he recovers it. Now, here's Mancini. Defense is right there.
Yeah, they call him Dancing Danny Green, and you can see why. Excellent offensive instincts there.
Celtics trail by 13. Here's Cousins. He dishes it to Williams. Four on the shot clock. With some arc. Doesn't get it to drop for him. Good work defensively by Millsap. Down low, Philadelphia moving the ball around. Now here is Harris. He's guarding closely.
DeAndre and Jordan.
James Harden. He's checked in for Danny Green. Here's Pritchard. Pass to Stauskas. Back to Williams. With the drive. Passes to Tice. Just five on the clock. And he can't stop this drought. Another miss. And he's fouled pretty hard on that shot, but he's got the chance to pick up the points at the line.
Yeah, you know, you can't get overly physical with Harris because once you do, he turns it against you and uses it for his good.
Guys, let's get your take on the scoring breakdown for the 76ers.
They've knocked down plenty of mid-range jumpers in this one. That's been big for them.
And I also love the way they move the basketball. Their passing has been outstanding here in the second half.
Jaylen Brown checked in for White. Williams passes to Pritchard. Here's Stauskas, guarded by Harris. No block shot. And it's off the back rim, no good. The 76ers leading by 15. Harden dishes to Jordan. Harden the pass to Jordan. And here's Maxey for three. Harris, the shot, no good.
He had 6 points from long range in the first half, but nothing's falling here since.
Stolen by Harden. And here's the fast break. Millsap leading the way. Maxey, no good. Here's Stauskas, guarded by Harden. And that one drops. Stauskas has got his second bucket tonight.
And not being as aggressive from the three-point line anymore, that they had a lot more attempts in that first half.
Here's Maxey. And slam dunk by Maxey.
Now, how about breaking out the Statue of Liberty on that dunk?
A nice way to pad that lead a little more. You're right.
Yes, indeedy. Well done.
Now here's Williams. Stauskas from the arc. It's hauled in by Harris. Harris has got his second three down here tonight. It's not going to go for him. And it's Boston the other way.
And he's been way off the mark this quarter. It's been ugly.
Going inside. A shot by Pritchard. No good. Here's Philadelphia. They're on a 13-5 run. It's good. Nice touch there from Maxey. Maxey's got 21 in the game.
Every time they get scored on during this run, it's come from inside the paint.
Pritchard passes to Brown. There's the lob to Brown. Shot clock and game clock separated by less than 6 seconds. Jordan kicks to Harris. Off target from outside.
He's tried to get it going, but the shots simply have not been there. Nothing seems to be falling.
To the wing right side. Pritchard passes to Stauskas. Brown outside. Over Harden. Boston, no good that time either. And so it's Philadelphia, out in front by 17 points at the end of the quarter. And their ability to get points in the paint has made all the difference in this one. And we've got more NBA action on 2K Sports coming your way after this break. While we have the chance now, folks, let's go to our State Farm assist of the game.
And I'm glad this was the pick because I love this pass. Such a great dish. That's what I call court vision.
Yeah, and with the accuracy to go along with that vision. I mean, he put the ball in the absolute perfect spot. That's how you orchestrate it.
And as we head into the fourth, we'll see if there's a comeback in the works or if it's more of the same from the first three quarters. Down on the block, it's Harris and Embiid. Harden out there with Maxey, and it's Feibel in at the small four. That's the group in the game for the 76ers.
You know, he's not a knockdown shooter from there, but when you're that uncovered, you almost are forced to take it.
Kicks it out to Harden. Now, here's Maxey. He's covered by Brown. Maxey, no good. Celtics trail by 17. And he makes the bucket, gets the whistle, and now a three-point play chance here for him.
What's up? Hey, when you're as strong and as physical as Horford is, you're going to have to deal with physical defense. That's just part of the territory. On the flip side of that, though, you're going to have some and-one opportunities, too.
And an area that's often underappreciated for Horford, he's a fantastic passer.
Nothing flashy. Great vision in the post or at the top of the key. And he just keeps it moving and finds the open man.
Williams with the clock. Blocked again. Here's Harden. And he drives in. Tough break there. Shot after shot. They couldn't get anything to fall. Here's Brown. No good there. And Philadelphia the other way now. Feibel on the wing. He kicks to Harden. Pass to Embiid. Fires the three. Massey, no good.
You know, even though they're on top in this one, you'd like him to be better out there because he's capable of being better. Sure would make things a lot easier, too.
Pass break, Philadelphia. Feibel, the pass to Maxey. Philadelphia moving the ball around. And they'll get another chance. Feibel can't get it to go.
No one to blame on that one but himself. You get looks like that, you've got to take advantage.
Here's Brown. Williams trying to break free. Tries again. Oh, he blocked it. Deflects off the backboard. Stolen by Smart. It off the glass. Smart's got 11 in the second half.
Boy, he's having a great half here. Exactly the opposite of the first.
Now, here's Maxey. He's guarded closer. Embiid. And the dunk by Embiid.
Embiid, what a show of force right there, going hard at the rim for the dunk.
At the top of the key, Williams. Outside, Horford. Aston Smith, and stolen by Feibel. Oh, and there's the alley-oop, and another turnover here by Philadelphia.
You know, that's just sloppy basketball giving away a possession. No real reason for that turnover.
Celtics trail by 14. Brown outside. A floater, and the rejection by Embiid. Here's Harden, and it's sent back by Horford. And the ball travels out of bounds. It was last touched by Smart. Reed is checked in for the 76ers. Here's Max to the inside. Whistle blows, and that's going to be a travel.
Seems to me as though he's lost his way a little bit in the second half. He'd been turnover free before the break. That's certainly not the case anymore.
Outside, Smart. Williams with the ball. Back to Smart. Over Maxey. Smart misses. And it's Harden with the ball for the Philadelphia 76ers. They've only given up 5 points here in the fourth quarter. Now here's Harden. Williams with the clock. Now Smart. Outside, Horford. The pass to Brown. shoot. Steps back and fires. And Philadelphia grabs the miss.
Misfires again, and the ball just refuses to cooperate with him. It's a tough day so far.
Harden, no good.
Nothing's going his way since the horn. I mean, looks like he used up all his makes in the last quarter.
It has not been his game so far. I mean, he's trying his best, giving great effort, but little has gone his way.
Feeds it to Reed. Ibel on the wing. A three-pointer off the mark. Celtics trail by 14. Nesmith, the pass to Smart. Kicks it to Horford. Passes it to Brown. And foul on the shot, so he'll get a chance at the line. Now that he's attracting so much defensive attention, Greg, Brown is routinely getting others involved.
And how about his assist numbers have skyrocketed? And it's really not surprising. His sole focus is doing what's best for the team.
First free throw is good.
And the vertical that Brown has is quite impressive. As relentless a finisher that you'll find in this league.
Timeout called, the 76ers.
Adjustments are a part of the game, and the coach sees something he doesn't like here.
And you know what? We'll see what changes he makes coming out of this timeout.
And let's catch up with our sideline reporter, David Aldridge.
Hey, Kevin, during the last break, I heard Doc Rivers talking with his team. He loves the aggressiveness on D. He said, we're doing a great job of challenging everything they're trying to do. Stay active, talk to each other, don't let up. Kevin?
Thank you, David.
And really, the defense fouling there to prevent the layup, but that's exactly what you need to do.
It is. I mean, no reason to back off from giving the layup. You're much better off making him go to the line.
And the first one drops.
Impeccable from the line since halftime.
No misses yet. Can't do much better than that, guys.
So he hits both of them. Celtics trail by 14. Smart passes to Brown. Trying to break that ice cold streak. He takes it up and lays it in. Brown's got 21.
Brown extremely accomplished down low and worthy of respect as a result. Destroys whoever tries to guard him in the paint.
Here's Reed, and he banks in the layup. And the 76ers lead by 14.
That's serving it up on the platter there. What a nice pass. A high percentage look was the result.
Brown outside. Inside, here's Williams. He can't get that one. Good D by Embiid. Harden dishes to Embiid. Bible. And here's Harden, and taken away by Brown. From down in the low post, it goes. Brown's got six in the quarter.
Coming off a big game, his confidence couldn't be higher, and coach knows it.
Showing no signs of slowing or cooling down. We're going to ride him as far as he can take it.
How many times have we seen the possession take that from them today? Ending with a basket, coming off a pretty pass.
Well, when you look at the assist totals, hey, they've been clearly the better team.
Now, here's Brown. And he slams it down right on top of Joel Embiid.
Brown with that amazing athleticism, putting on a show out there with jams like that.
And that was another look at the aggressive D that led to the Mobile 1-1.
And guys, they'll think twice about attempting that shot again. That was a big-time rejection.
The lead now cut to single digits. Brown's got 28 points for the game.
And you're asking for more trouble than you can handle if you're going to let him just roam free from beyond the arc.
And it's blocked by Brown. Smart deciding where to go with it. Aston Nesmith. And foul on the shot. He'll shoot two at the free throw line.
Aaron Nesmith.
No good on the free throw.
Wow, what, he have something in his eye on that shot?
The 76ers making a switch here. Harris has checked in. The 76ers leading by eight. Here's Harden. Levine trying to break loose. And the jam by Harden.
Ferociousness from Harden. Looking like he's going to tear the rim off.
Boston's got the three-point shot off 16 times tonight. 7 times they've hit it. 9 times they've missed. Now a timeout called by Boston.
And he has not been on his game here. He's forcing a lot of shots. And the team is suffering because of it. It's time for him to focus on getting his teammates involved.
And now, let's take a look at the New Balance player of the game, Joel Embiid.
And when he's been on the floor, it has been a clinic in rim protection and shot blocking. He's played the defense of 3 men tonight. His block total has gotten to a point you almost never see in an NBA game.
He sure has given this crowd a treat tonight. This kind of performance only cements his status as a fan favorite. Here's Brown.
You know, it's awesome to see Harden giving his all on defense. That's been an area that he's needed to improve on. Really making an effort to stay with his guy.
Harden the pass to Embiid. Out of bounds, Boston takes possession.
Yeah, and I think he was surprised to see that pass coming his way and just really reacted too late.
Celtics trail by 8. Smart finds William. Again with the block. Making his presence felt on this end.
He's hosting down the fort, anchoring the defense.
Sixers on defense. The biggest lead of the game was 24 points.
He didn't have a single point in the first half. Bagel, 0 points, nada.
He's starting to get into the groove here in the second.
And if you give him an inch of space, he's going to make you pay.
Here's Smart, and there's the try. Rejected by Harris.
What a block from Harris. Terrific work there.
Pocket 6. And foul on the shot, so he'll get a chance at the line.
James Harden.
Throw good, James Harden.
Harden's career, as we all know, is littered with huge stats, but he recently became the first player in NBA history to post a 30-point triple-double in a debut game with a new team.
Second free throw, no good. Celtics trail by 9. Brown dishes to Williams. Smart passes to Williams. He kicks it to Brown. Into the lane, throws it down as the official calls the foul. It may be a 3-point play. Maxey, and so he's picked up his final foul. He will sit for the rest of this game. And the 76ers making a change here. Korkmaz is checked in. And so it's Harden bringing it up for the 76ers. He feeds it to Embiid. It's good. The assist that time from Harden. Harden's got assist number 8 now on the night.
The assist from James Harden.
Brown against Harden. Elbow shot is on the way. Good on the jump shot. Brown's got 35 in the game.
Great quarter for him at the offensive end, trying to will his team back in the game.
Harden with the stuff.
reputation that's well earned in this league as an elite scorer.
Now, here's Brown. And a lot of contact on that one, so he'll shoot two here. It's going to be on James Harden. First one falls. Shake Milton is checked in for Korkmaz. And Brown drops it both.
And great work at the line there to chip away at the lead. A few more productive trips here, and things could really get interesting.
Now, here's Milton. .157 left to play here in the fourth. Embiid. Horford with the rebound. Horford's got rebound number 8 here tonight in the game. Smart kicks to Horford. Cotton drives in, and the basket is good. Brown's got 39.
Hey, and with Brown, guys, it doesn't matter what point in the game it is. I mean, he's ready to shoot whenever he has the ball in a good spot.
Harden against Smart. Harden the best in Embiid. It doesn't go for him. Williams with the defensive effort. Celtics trail by 4. Side Brown. Side shot opportunity. Offensive rebound. Williams gets to Smart. It's deflected. And shoot again. Here's Williams. And again with the rebound. He holds in his 20th rebound.
Dominating the glass. And you can't get a bigger bucket than that.
Well, that was one too. He wanted the ball. Nobody else was taking that shot.
There's the pass to Milton. Shot clock is at 3. Shoots over Brown. Misses off the left iron.
Can't afford any wasted possessions down the stretch.
The defense needs to be just as sharp, but it's not over yet.
And they commit an intentional foul. It's another one of those, so they can get into the penalty.
Honestly, just doing what they have to in order to get the basketball back.
That's a good foul, though. I like that. Clock management at this time of the game.
It's the first. That mentioned a 3-point lead. Second one is good. And both at the line. It's a 4-point ball game.
And I don't need to tell you guys, those free throws are big. 2-possession game now.
Now, timeout called by Boston. They're down by 4. 20 seconds left in the fourth quarter. What's your take, guys?
They're trying to stay alive. They've got to work quickly.
Okay, they're going to draw up a play here, I think, to get a shot right off of the inbounds pass to not waste too much time at all.
And there have been some terrible shot choices here. Yeah, that's not a good look at all.
They're going to prolong the game here with an intentional foul. He hits the first one, and that puts them up by 5. Both free throws here, so now it's a 6-point ball game.
And that's the knockout blow right there, guys. Those free throws should put this one away.
Time call here. The Celtics decide to talk it over. They trail by 6. They've got 13 seconds left to play in the final quarter. Guys, your thoughts?
There's still a sliver of hope.
Yeah, but they've got to score and then foul immediately.
Here's Brown. Yes!
James Brown is so creative at picking apart the defense with his ball handle. You gotta love how clever he is with the ball.
And they stop the clock as soon as they can with the intentional foul.
You have to foul, but I'm sure they would have liked to foul someone different.
They didn't really have another option. I mean, I thought they did a nice job getting it in his hands and making sure he was the guy who'd go to the line.
8 seconds left in the fourth. Over to the left wing. And the 3 off target.
So the 76ers win it. They didn't make it easy on themselves or their fans, but in the end, everyone satisfied.
I mean, there were some times that momentum shifted and it...
Thank you, David. Great interview once again. And that's going to do it tonight, folks, for our broadcast. For Greg Anthony, Clark Kellogg, and David Alden, this is Kevin Harlan. Thanks for watching the NBA on 2K Sports.